Okay, so we have been looking at second order differential equations. We started with the homogeneous version of the second order linear differential equation with constant coefficients, right? So first we said that we are interested in second order differential equations. Then we said that okay, let's look at the linear differential equations because they're easier to solve. Then we said okay, let's look at just the homogeneous version of it. It turns out that even the homogeneous second order differential equation in its full generality, you know, does not have a completely general solution, right? So, but if you have constant coefficients, we have given the prescription for it. But I mean, the more general homogeneous second order differential equation, even if it is linear, can be quite complicated. But in this lecture, we will see that if by some means we're able to guess one solution, we can also find there is a general prescription to find another linearly independent solution for an arbitrarily complicated linear homogeneous second order differential equation, right? So that's what this lecture is about. Okay, so the most general second order homogeneous linear differential equation is of this form, right? So you can write it as this. There is a second order term, it has to be there, d squared y over dx squared. Then you can have some function of x sitting here instead of a constant coefficient, right? We looked at how to solve this problem if you have constant coefficients, but in general you can have a p of x here, dy by dx, and it's still linear, and a q of x also here, right? So this can be a hard problem even if it's a homogeneous differential equation. However, if by some means you are able to guess one solution, so we will show how you can also find the other solution, right? So suppose you are able to, you know, by some means get one solution, let's call it y1 of x, then you know the method involves writing, you know, rewriting this differential equation in terms of a v. So we look for a solution v y2 of x, which is v of x times y1 of x. Right. So we plug this y2 of x, suppose y2 of x is a solution, then now you get a differential equation in v, right? So you have dy by 2 by dx is equal to y1 first derivative with respect to v plus v times dy1 by dx, and then you can also compute d squared y2 by dx squared, which will be y1 d squared v by dx squared plus v times d squared y1 plus dx squared, and then you get 2 times, you know, this dv by x times dy1x by dx, right, as you can explicitly verify. Now if you plug these expressions, right, into your original differential equation and then use the fact that y1 is a solution of this, right, you are already given that y1 is a solution, then you can show that you get a differential equation in terms of v, d squared v by dx squared, y1 plus dv by dx times 2 dy1 by dx plus p times y1 is equal to 0, right? So I will leave it as homework for you to verify this, right? So, you know, basically all you have to do is plug this expression for d squared y2 by dx squared and expression for dy2 by dx and expression for y2 into this equation, into this differential equation, and use the fact that y1 itself is a solution of this, which means that d squared y1 by dx squared plus p of x dy1 by dx plus q of x y1 equal to 0. If you use these two facts, it will simplify, and your differential equation in terms of v is given by this expression. So here y1 is a known function, right? We should keep that in mind. V is the unknown, right? We want to find a v such that ultimately our interest is y2, right? Okay, let's see what this differential equation is. We have a differential equation in v, which is a homogeneous second order differential equation. So you might be wondering, so have we accomplished anything? Well, the answer is yes. So if we make the substitution w is equal to dv by dx, we'll be able to write this differential equation as dw by dx. So in place of d squared v by dx squared, we have dw by dx times y1 plus in place of dv by dx, we just put in w of x times 2 dy1 by dx plus py1 is equal to 0. So the key point is that now it's a separable differential equation in terms of w. So you can actually just write this as 1 over w dw by dx is equal to some function of x, which is seen to be minus 2 by y1 dy1 by dx minus p. So you can just go ahead and integrate. So I have log of w of x is equal to minus log of y1 squared minus integral p of x dx, or you can, you know, basically write w of x is equal to 1 over y1 squared times e to the minus integral p dx, right? So there is a constant which, you know, comes out from this integration, but you will see in a moment that this doesn't matter. So we will ignore this constant. So we have this another round of integration will give us integral 1 over y1 squared e to the minus integral p of p dx, the whole thing dx is a formal solution of this differential equation in V. So from which we can immediately write down y2, right? So the claim is that the solution y2 that we have found is a linearly independent solution, right? We have given a prescription for V, and we can actually verify that y2 is linearly independent, right? To do this, we check the Wronskian. Wronskian, as you would remember, is given by this determinant of this matrix. So you must put in y1 and y2, you know, you are given two functions y1 and y2, then you must take the derivatives dy1 by dx and then dy2 by dx. If you take the determinant of this function, so but we know that dy2 by dx is dv by, so since y2 is equal to v times y1, you can write it as dv by dx into y1 plus v times dy1 by dx, and then you expand this, so you see a lot of cancellations, and then you'll be just left with this term y1 squared dv by dx, which in turn can be written like here, and the final answer is just e to the minus integral p of x dx, and it's the exponential of, you know, some function, so this is not identically zero. Therefore, indeed, you know, you remember the condition that when a Wronskian is not identically zero, it means that it's, you're working with linearly independent functions. So y1 and y2 are two linearly independent functions, and therefore, since they are both solutions of your second order differential equation, so the general equation, the general solution for the second order differential equation can be written down as y of x is equal to c1 times y1 of x plus c2 times y2 of x, right? So all of this is best understood with the help of an example. So let's look at an example. So I have this equation x squared plus 1 d squared y by dx squared minus 2x dy by dx plus 2y equal to 0. So as you can see, because of the appearance of this x squared plus 1 and minus 2x, you know, this is not the same level of an easy problem as, you know, what we did with constant coefficients. It's linear for sure, it's homogeneous, but it does not have constant coefficients. However, you can see that, you know, if you are able to find a y, if you can guess a linear function which, you know, just solves this part alone, right, that's going to be a solution for the full thing, because if you take the second derivative of a linear function, it's going to be just zero, right? And in this case, it turns out to be completely trivial to find what that linear function is, just y1 is equal to x. So you see, anyway, this part is not going to contribute, and y1 is equal to x is indeed a solution for this differential equation. So we immediately found, so you see that, you know, this part will give you a minus 2x plus 2x, which is zero, right? So we have found one solution just by inspection, and we want to find another solution. So let's try out this one, y2 of x is equal to x times v of x. So if you take the derivative of this, it's going to be v of x plus x times dv by dx. Now we plug, so we also find one more derivative, d squared y2 of x divided by dx squared is dv by dx plus x times d squared v by dx squared plus dv by dx. Now we plug this, all these three expressions back into the original differential equation, and, you know, and there are these simplifications which follow, and then we get this differential equation, which is a second order differential equation in V. So we have x into x squared plus 1. You should check this to see that all the algebra is right. So you get x times x squared plus 1 times d squared V by dx squared plus 2 dV by dx is equal to 0. So now, as we have seen in the general prescription, the way to make progress is to write this as a differential equation in W, which is dV by dx, and then x into x squared plus 1 dW by dx plus 2W of x is equal to 0, right. So this is basically, you know, the type of differential equation where it's second order, but it's effectively first order, right, as we have seen, right. You work with the derivative, and then you get a first order equation in terms of the first derivative, and then that's what is happening. So you have a first order differential equation. So you have dw by dx, so it's also separable, so it's just a matter of integrating this function, right. You do partial fractions, you separate this out, and then you integrate, so you get log of w of x plus some constant, which is, we'll just put it to 0, and since in the end we are going to have only two arbitrary constants. So if you can find one solution to this differential equation, that's good. You don't have to find the completely general solution for v of x. So it's convenient here to just take this constant to be 0. So you get w of x, which is that first derivative of v, to be just 1 plus 1 over x squared. You should check the algebra. It's fairly straightforward. It's just a matter of integrating and carefully collecting all the factors and everything. So since w of x is equal to 1 plus 1 over x squared, we have to do one more integration, and we get v of x is equal to x minus 1 by x, where once again we have ignored a constant of, which is not very important, right. So because we are not in after finding the most general solution for v, we are only interested in finding one solution of v of x. So what we have managed to show is y2 is equal to x times v of x, which is x squared minus 1, is a solution of the original differential equation, and it's a linearly independent solution with respect to y1. So we have found two linearly independent solutions of the second order linear differential equation, and therefore you can just take an arbitrary constant times the first solution plus an arbitrary another arbitrary constant times the second solution, and then you have the full solution for the full general solution for the original differential equation. Okay, that's all for this lecture. Thank you.